You also found that animals that were fed during a 9-hour period had improved endurance.
Yeah.
Not improved muscle strength, but improved endurance. And to me, when I read this, I thought, oh, well, if you think about endurance is aerobic. It requires aerobic respiration, which means it requires oxygen, which means it requires mitochondria, because mitochondria are what make energy in the presence of oxygen.
Yeah.
So have you thought about looking, and this kind of goes along with your NAD hypothesis, but have you looked at mitochondrial biogenesis, mitochondrial function?
Yeah, so the endurance is a very interesting aspect, because we see that only when mice eat for 8 to 9 hours. We don't see that improved endurance when they eat for 12 hours, although their body weight is maintained as 9 hours. So this was interesting. So that's why, as you pointed out, clearly mitochondria might be playing a role. And in fact, in liver, we do see increased mitochondria volume and increased endoplasmic reticulum volume. So ER is also, ER and mitochondria kind of work together. That's what we are learning these days. So the mitochondria volume increases. Another thing is we do see less damaged mitochondria in liver when they eat only for 8 to 9 hours. Second thing is this mitochondria effect is not restricted only to liver. We do see increased mitochondria volume in brown adipose tissue. So in brown fat, as you know, this mitochondria health kind of dissipate heat, really literally burning the fat. So at least in two different organs, we have seen increased mitochondrial volume. That correlates with increased level of PGC1 alpha that's involved in mitochondria biogenesis. So there is all these links that we are seeing, and that are also giving us clue where to look for the mechanism. For example, why PGC1 level goes up and what triggers that to go up.